Good morning, welcome to Everything Science. I'm Solidi Major.
What's the matter?
Just then, Dr. Keller and Miss Lisa got trapped in the giant ice cube. They were fine, but they were guessing how could they melt ice cube faster than normal. Over to you, liquidy volume.
I'm here with our scientist, Mattery Texter, and our questioner, Reflect Pam. Over to you, Reflect Pam. How can ice melt faster?
My hypothesis is that ice can melt faster by making a machine.
Back to you, Solidy Measure.
Okay, now let's see how does the scientist solve their problems.
These are the materials you need in this experiment. One sushi plate, two toilet paper rolls, make sure they don't have paper on them. One CD, one iPad lid, one plastic bowl, one piece of cotton as big as the sushi plate, one hot glue gun, and one ice cube without water leaking.
First, take one iPad lid. Carefully pull out the iPad thin part.
Then get two toilet paper rolls. Cut the tip, but only a little bit, and gently glue the paper roll near the side on the small side of the iPad lid.
Glue the bottom on the sushi plate and stick it under the paper roll.
Grab a cotton and glue it on the sushi plate.
Get one CD.
Glue the CD on top of the plastic bowl and put the bowl on the cotton.
Then get two ice cubes.
Then take one ice cube and put it on the melting machine.
And the one ice cube in the plastic plate.
And see what happens.
We used to think that we can melt the ice cube faster by making a machine. But then we noticed the ice cube on the plastic plate melt faster than the melting machine. That's because the CD reflects the sunlight. Reflect means when the sun hits the CD, the sunlight bounces off the CD so the CD temperature doesn't heat up. Now we know the cotton soak up the water of the ice cube and the temperature stay cool, so the melting machine didn't work. But I still wonder why the CD don't reflect the sunlight to the ice cube.
Thank you for watching Everything Science. Good night.